Creating a VHDL project in QRDIS 2. Depending on how QRDIS 2 has been used on your computer before, you may start up to this screen, or you may encounter a couple of screens before you get here. The first one you might encounter is a look and feel screen. If that's the case, you want to select QRDIS 2 look, click OK, and that might take you to, depending on whether you're working on a network or not, might take you to a license form. If that's the case, you would need to get the valid license path from your teacher and enter it into the settings area. If you get past that, you might get a window asking you if you want to create a new project, in which case say yes. If you don't, you may come to this blank screen, in which case we're going to start and create a new project. So we're going to go up to File and say New Project Wizard. And this is the point that if you get the box asking you if you want to create a new project, it would take you to this if you clicked OK. So we click Next, and what we want to do is we want to browse to a working directory for your program. Ideally, you'll have already set up a folder. I've called mine Altera Samples. You can click out and you can browse to that. So here you can see I have some projects already in there. We say OK or Open. Then we want to name our project. So let's call it Sample 1. You'll notice it automatically comes in as the top-level design entity for the project as well. So what that means is in your VHDL code, your design entity needs to have this name. If you want it to be called something else, you should change it here in this field down here. Otherwise, leave it alone once you get to your VHDL file. So we click Next. And it's saying that inside that folder, I already have a project. It's saying, do I want to set up a different directory? No, it's okay, we can put multiple projects in one folder. So I'm going to say, no, I don't want to. Then second page is asking me if I want to add any files. Well, I don't have any files yet to include in my file, so I'm going to click Next. The next one's an important one. So we want to make sure here that we get the right family of processors. So here's where we're selecting our FPGA information. So we want to make sure we have Cyclone 2 selected from the drop-down box here. And down here, we have EP2C20F484C7. So this one's pretty important. If we don't do this properly, we're not going to be able to connect to the FPGA properly. So once we have those selected, we hit Next. On page 4, we don't need to do anything, so we're going to say Next. And here, the only thing to do to check is to make sure that our processor information here in the middle is correct. We click Finish, and we're ready to go. We can see our project has been set up. It's called Sample 1. Now it's time to add a file to that, where we're actually going to put our VHDL. So we click File, we click New, we choose VHDL file from the bottom, say OK, and it gives us a working area, so we can make that full size in our window. Right now it has a default name, VHDL1. If we click Save, it by default is going to name it the same as our project. We make sure that this box down here is clicked to add it to the project. We say Save, and we're now ready to go. Our file is called sample1.vhd. VHD is a standard extension for our VHDL files, and we're ready to enter our VHDL code.